I just wanted to know if there's any news on Anthony Joshua, what might happen next with him, if you're looking at a date, looking at opponents, what's the kind of state of play with him?
In Thailand at the moment, and judging by Snapchats, I wish I was in Thailand as well. Yeah. And I think that he'll box in November, middle or end, and I think it'll be between Parker, Stavern and Pulev. I think they're the three guys. Spoke to Parker's team at the weekend. Seem like very nice people. They have a clear plan in place. I don't think they're rushing to fight Anthony Joshua because I think they're in a similar boat where they feel like he's going to get better. But AJ likes the Parker fight. I think he wants to get that dealt with. I think it's a good fight. But Pulev's a great test for him. Stavern's a great test for him. And, you know, I think it will more than likely come from one of those three. Or Manchester. Yeah, yeah. I mean, everything, there's only two arenas that can take him. That's Manchester and the O2. So, and sometimes not all aren't available. So I quite like the idea of taking him to Manchester. You know, we haven't done it for a long time, taking him to the Northwest. So, of course, there's demand wherever we go. But I looked at the Millennium Stadium as well. But it's a big punt.
Yeah. And taking him to America is...
Not for now. Not for now. I mean, there's loads of conversations. Oman, Nigeria, Ghana, China, Dubai. These are all either governments or tourist boards that have come on to try and stage an Anthony Joshua fight. And that's of massive interest to us, providing we can get the right model and the right security. On the numbers, not security as in, you know, FBI or whatever. But we want to do something different with Anthony Joshua, like these fighters are trying to do something different, you know, and do something great. And that might be to go out and, you know, you announce that Anthony Joshua's fighting in China. And that's groundbreaking. You know, everyone might sort of go, what's going on? But that is, and we want to do that. We want to box in America. But for now, you know, but you've got Fury Klitschko. God knows what's happening with that fight. You've got David Haye in the mix as well. And I think they're the fights, realistically, we can look at next summer. But for now, we want to plan November and probably March and then look for the unification in the summer.
Do you have any sort of regrets in the way your situation with Carl was when he was with Matchroom and you guys?
Not really, because that was a long time ago, you know. And despite people thinking that I sit at home with a voodoo doll of Carl Frampton and a needle, I completely respect and never really. I'm not like the kind of guy that sits here going, "Please don't win, please don't win." If you're good enough to go and win, fair play to you, and that's a fantastic win. And when you see the togetherness of the team, I know how that feels. So I have admiration for them rather than regret. I couldn't work in that environment. I wouldn't have been true to myself if I did. So therefore, I can't have any regrets. If he was with me, he would have earned a lot more money for that fight and he'd be a pay-per-view fighter. So he'd be making millions every fight. He's a very good fighter. And despite, you know, Shane McGuigan likes to give me sly digs and call me a wanker behind my back and all sorts, he's an excellent trainer. Barry McGuigan is, you know, been a huge part of the journey, and I have admiration for that team. Never, you know, disgust or regret. I really am genuinely pleased for them because I know what it would have meant to them. And they did take the fight for small money in comparison to the. But once you've got the money like they got against Quigg, you're kind of like free rolling, if that makes sense. So for me, and it's hard to tell fans, first thing I'll sit down and want to do for you as a fighter is make sure that you are secure for life. From there, we're free rolling. Yeah. So let's go and be great now. You know, you've had the big fights, you beat Quigg, you got the paydays. Now let's go and be great. Well, the first step is go to America, move up a fight, wait, fight Santa Cruz. Done. Now, you know, I won't go too much into the contractual side, but, you know, we're pushing for a rematch with Carl Frampton. And I think that's got to be next. Yeah. And I would probably think they've got a rematch with Santa Cruz. But I mean, don't worry too much about what's said. I think I would be surprised if there wasn't a rematch called. Then you've got the Lee Selby fight. So, it's interesting times. You know, Quigg is desperate to fight Frampton again. You've got a Selby fight. But Frampton, by the way, is not going to fight till November, December. Lee Selby's boxed twice in 16 months and he ain't got a date. He should have boxed four times, maybe five times in that period. So are you going to say to him, you now have to wait till December to fight, or do you want to fight Josh Warrington in October, November? You know, but there's all kinds of different. I mean, if I was Santa Cruz now, and don't forget they've got the same advisor, I would be saying, right, what's the date for the rematch? Right, you've just had the fight of the year out of me. I've lost my belt. It was a voluntary defence. Right, where's the rematch? Can't be in Belfast because it's a winter fight. Let's do it in LA. No, well, the compromise is actually do it in New York again. Let's this time open the top tier at the Barclays Centre, because you have to realise this is a great fight, a big fight. And by the way, the Irish will come in their trebles next time, even the expats, the local guys, and do that fight again. Lee Selby will be saying to Al Heyman, right, give me the unification then, because I've only had two fights and, you know, you told me I'd be in the big fights, well, there's a perfect chance. You know, I mean, people come to me and say, that's a huge pay-per-view fight. It's not. You know, Quigg against Frampton, which was the biggest fight either guy could be involved with by a mile, did disappointing numbers, right? It wasn't a flop, but it didn't.
Better or worse than Belly?
Worse. Yeah. Quite, but that did good numbers. Yeah, I mean, but they also had a big card. Frampton against Selby is definitely not a Sky pay-per-view fight. But there are three or four broadcasters right now who are planning to do pay-per-view boxing. So, they can, you know, I've got one fight left with Lee Selby, right? So I've got to be involved in the TV. If it's not on Sky, okay, just, you know, we'll come up with a deal. But it doesn't, for me, with the fights that are out there at the moment, I can't get that fight on Sky pay-per-view. A bit like Crawler Lenares. You know, people say to me, well, that's a pay-per-view fight. I said, says who? Me. I want to see that. I said, yeah, but it doesn't deliver the numbers. We know what delivers the numbers. Anthony Joshua, Brook against Gennady Golovkin, Brook against Khan, Hay against Joshua, Fury against Joshua, Fury against Mayweather against Pacquiao. You know, and I think there are that many big fights out there at the moment that it's going to take something substantial now, which is good news for the fans again, to make that pay-per-view cut. Do you know what I mean?